I'm Sin with the OSINT Dojo, and in this video, we're going to cover how to make a basic Discord bot to collect OSINT information. Such bots are a simple way to query information using an API and can be added to your Discord server to facilitate quick OSINT collection. Before getting started, you will need both a Discord account as well as an API key and the documentation to the API of your choice. I'll be using ipgeolocation.io, which offers a free account as well as a quota of free API calls. Once you have these, head on over to discord.com/developers. From here, click on New Application, and then enter a name for your bot. Click the checkbox, and then click Create. Next, we'll enter a description and save our changes before clicking on Installation. We're going to copy the install link and open this in a new window. We'll click Add to Server and then make sure the correct server is chosen within the dropdown before clicking Authorize. I'm going to go back and remove the install link so that it cannot be added to any other servers before saving my changes. Next, we're going to click on Bot. This is where you get the token needed for your code, so make sure that you note that down for later. We'll scroll down and uncheck Public Bot, and then check Message Content Intent so that our bot can send messages to the server with a response to our query. Let's save our changes and move on over to our code. Here I have a simple code template to make it easier for you to get started on your first Discord bot. I've included a link to this template in the description below. Starting here at the top, we have the imports necessary to run our bot. The first couple here are related to the Discord bot itself. We're also going to use the request library for obtaining data from our API. And then, our last line here is importing both our API key and our Discord token from a config.py file. We do this so that it's not embedded within our code template. You could also use environment variables or an env file here instead. Next, we have some configurations for our bot, specifically related to the intents, like the message content one that we enabled previously. We also have the command prefix for our bot, which, for us, will be the standard slash command. We follow that up with the code to sync our bot, as well as for printing a message to our terminal to let us know that it's running. Now we get into the part of the code that you will need to edit in order to customize your bot. We're going to start off by giving our command a name as well as a description. We can then enter the prompt that we want to display to the user when they run the bot, as well as change the function name here. Now we need to locate the documentation for our API and get the URL structure. If we scroll down, we can see an example of how we need to structure our requests. Let's integrate that into our code template. Our URL variable now contains the necessary format, including our API key, as well as the IP address collected from the user. The next line makes a request to the URL that we created. It then saves the response to the response variable. Then, the following line gets us the JSON version of this response. Finally, we need to craft how our bot will reply to our users. Let's go back to the documentation and view the format that the responses come in. For our example, the specific data points I want to output are the IP address, the country name, and the ISP. We'll type out IP here, and then add the JSON response variable that contains a JSON response from our request, as well as note the specific data point that we want to return, which, in this case, is the IP address. We'll then add slash n which will move the output to a new line, and then repeat the same format using our country name as well as the ISP. We list ephemeral as true here at the end. This is optional, but simply means that the output will only be displayed to the user running the command. Running the code, it looks like we have an error somewheres. It looks like our bot's name needs to be all lowercase, and we can't have any spaces. Let's fix that and try to run it again. Looks like the bot is now running successfully. Let's move over to our Discord server and test it out. When we type our slash command here, we're not seeing our new IP lookup command. To fix this, we need to refresh the page. Now that our new command shows up, let's submit a sample IP address. Looks like everything is functioning as expected, and we received the requested information from our bot. Keep in mind, we've barely scratched the surface on what is possible. Once you understand the basics, you can add additional functionality, migrate your bot to a cloud server, or maybe incorporate rate limits or access controls so that it's only usable by specific roles or within certain channels on your Discord server.